I think basically what you got to understand is we are from migrant community, our forefathers. So race was part of their lives because they belong to the respective countries they represented. But what happened in the process was me being born here, second, third, fourth generation. And we identify with this nation and we find it very difficult to identify with the race or the community that we belong to. We want to identify as Malaysians. But somehow the whole process of the system is, it's all based on race. You are a Chinese, you are an Indian, or a Malay, or you belong to some other races, which is very difficult for those who are born here, because we don't speak the Indian language, we don't follow the traditional customs or practices, and we don't even eat the traditional foods. We are just like any of us here, sharing the same dreams, same aspirations to move forward. But somehow the system has made it that everything is on a race-based quota system, and therefore in every area you have to struggle. In universities, in job professions, in civil services, in armed forces, in the police, in the judiciary, priority is given to a certain community, and others who have the equivalent qualifications are sometimes denied of these privileges and positions. And that creates a lot of discomfort in many other areas. See here, unfortunately, I think race and religion somehow is connected. See, for example, the Chinese mostly are Buddhists. See, they are always known as Buddhists, though there are Christians and other forms of worship within the community. And Taoists are also here. The Indians are mostly Hindus, but at the same time, we have Christians and other religious practices. And you got to accept that the Indians also are people from different parts of India. The Sikhs are mostly Punjabis, and those from Tamil Nadu mostly, and you know, they are mostly Hindus. And even from Kerala, people are from Kerala. They speak Malayalam languages. There are people from Andhra speaking languages, and even sometimes even Sri Lankans are also put in the category of Indians. So somehow the mindset is Malays are Muslim, and the law is defined in that way. The Malay is not Muslim. The Buddhists are mostly the Chinese, and the Hindus are mostly the Indians. And that is how race and religion has been identified. But and again, you got to accept the fact that within the Indian community there are various languages, there are various customs, and even the caste system also plays a part in their lives. So we got to accept that there are a lot of things that are different, but we need to accept that as Malaysians, we don't want to identify as an Indian, because I can't say I'm an Indian because I'm a Malayali. A Tamil is a Tamil. A Punjabi is a Punjabi. How do you put them as Indians and say this is a race? It's very, for us, it's a bit humiliating in that sense. It has been defined that a Malay is a Muslim, and that means you put them as a different class. And again, then we come every time it's a Muslims and non-Muslims. The Bhumiputras and non-Bhumiputras. So always a clear distinction has been seen. And therefore, people are not very comfortable, because we want to be seen as one, in spite of our religious beliefs and the way we look. It doesn't matter, as long as we can work together, appreciating and recognizing one another. And that's a desire of the present generation. No, indiscrimination is in the process. Like you say, we had our religious people and we have our religious worshipping places. But sometimes restrictions are being placed by saying if you want to build a bigger place, you need to go through the processes. And sometimes the guidelines that has been there makes it difficult for us. Recently, the guideline that you must have, if you want to build a non-Muslim worshipping place, there must be 100 meters distance. I mean, that's not practical. Because we have learned to live with one another. It doesn't matter if you have, if a mosque is next to my house or a temple is next beside my house, it doesn't disturb me. But why this particular ruling or guideline that if you want to have a non-religious worshipping center, the distance must be 100 meters. So again, it creates a kind of a difference, a distinctiveness that you are different from the other person, that you are not able to live and accommodate one another. And these are messages that comes out that separates the people more and more. And so that's dangerous. And again, the reason, one of the guidelines, they say, is you shouldn't have worshipping centers resembling Islamic or Malay architecture. But who defines what is a Malay and what is an Islamic architecture? If that's the case, the dome is seen all over Europe. Even the Sikh will not be able to build a worshipping center because they also have a dome. And that's a problem recently in Perak, which their building was not approved. Because in their building, worshipping structure, they had the dome. So these are restrictions. Then they have make restrictions that you must so many number of people within certain place, then only you can have a worshipping center. But this is about a freedom of worship. If I have 50 or 100 people want to worship in one place, why can't they have a place to meet and worship? Because then you have to look for a place far away, which is impossible. And religious education is part and parcel of the Asian community, because we need to be related to our temples or churches. And that is how we identify ourselves. The restrictions like this will not help. It creates more doubts and suspicion on the other community.